हेलो, ग्रीटिंग्स फ्रॉम ई पीजी पाठशाला. आई एम हितैषी दीवानजी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट, इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट, एलडी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग. आई वुड बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी. सिक्योरिटी हैज़ बीन द मेजर आस्पेक्ट टू कंसिडर इन टूडेज वर्ल्ड, बी इट अ फिजिकल सिक्योरिटी और इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी. फिजिकल सिक्योरिटी यानी यू आर सिक्योरिंग योर एसेट्स फिजिकली बाय लॉकिंग द डोर्स, बट व्हाट अबाउट इंफॉर्मेशन? इट कैन नॉट बी लॉक्ड बाय लॉक्स. सो इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी हाउ टू ऑब्टेन, दैट वुड बी कवर्ड थ्रू आउट दिस सब्जेक्ट. वी वुड बी फोकसिंग ऑन थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सिक्योरिटी: इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी, कंप्यूटर सिक्योरिटी एंड नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी. Information security includes that the information should be protected from unauthorized access. Unauthorized access means one who is not allowed to access the information, still he or she is accessing the information. The other aspects of information security includes that securing the information from disruption and distraction. Modification. Disruption yani the data has been disordered. Destruction yani data has been destroyed. Modification is original data has been changed. Then comes computer security. Computer security is securing the information which is stored on your hard disk or any other secondary devices. Network security includes storing the information when it is being transferred from computer to computer. First is security violation. When security violation occurs, user A is transmitting a file to user B which contains bank account information. Between A and B, C is there. What C is doing? He or she is not authorized, but it captures the file and observes what is being transmitted in a file. So C would be able to read the bank account number. This is the first security violation. The second security violation occurs when user A transmits a message to B. User C is altering the message by adding or deleting and then forwards it to B. This is the second type of security violation. The third type of security violation occurs when network manager transmits a message to a computer. The user C intercepts the message and constructs its own message and gives it to B. This is the third security violation. The fourth security violation occurs when customer C places an order to company B for supplying the goods. When a company B supplies the goods, the customer is saying, I have never placed the order. Customer is denying that he placed the order. So these are the four security violations. OSI security architecture. So ITU, that is International Telecommunication Union, Telecommunication Standardized Sector ITUT, that develops the standards relating to open system interconnection, that is called OSI. OSI security architecture was developed in context of OSI protocol architecture. When we talk about OSI security architecture, we consider three things: security attack, security mechanism and security service. Security attack is an action that compromises the security of information that is owned by the organization. Security mechanism is when a security attack occurs, it protects, deletes, prevents or recovers from a security attack. Security service is nothing but that counter the security attacks by using one or more security mechanisms. Then comes security policy. Security policy is a policy information technology security policy that identifies the rules and procedures for all who are accessing and using organizations' IT assets and resources. When we talk about information security, there are three key terms that is always discussed in the literature. The first is vulnerability, the second is threat, and third is attacks. Vulnerability is weakness of the system. If you are working on a computer and somebody is transmitting data from other computer, it is sent via network. That data is recorded on the port. So which ports are open to be accessed from outside, that creates a security vulnerability. So in other words, vulnerability is nothing but the open doors through which attacker can enter into our system. The second is threat. Threat is a potential cause of an incident that may result in a harm of systems or organizations. Attack is nothing but an assault on the system security that is derived from an intelligent threat. When you talk about ATM security, that somebody, the attacker, hacks into the ATM machine. That is an attack on the system. So it is nothing but invading the security services and violating the security policy of the system. Example of attack I can give is password attack or password guessing. The whole web is working on a login system. Whenever you enter into any website, what you have to do is login. So that is nothing but entering a password. So if attacker tries to guess a password and he is able to get this password, that is called the password attack. Security attacks are of two types, passive attacks and active attacks. Passive attack is nothing but gathering information. The attacker does not participate in the information, it just gathers the information. Active attack, yani system resources are changed or operations are altered. Types of passive attacks. First is release of message content. Example is Bob is sending data to the Alice through internet or other communication facilities. What does Darth do? Darth reads the content of the message which is passing from Bob to Alice. So what happened in this case? The Darth only gathered the information. He did not do anything else with the information. The second type of passive attack is traffic analysis. Bob is transmitting the data to the Alice. What a Darth is doing? Darth observes the traffic and find pattern of the messages from Bob to Alice. What kind of pattern can be observed? So pattern is how many times the bank transactions are being done, how many times a user is doing the net banking transactions. That kind of traffic analysis can be done. Then comes the second type of attack, that is called active attack. Active attack first is masquerade. So Bob is again talking to the Alice through internet or some communication facilities, but then what happens? Message is sent from Darth to Alice, but Alice thinks that it has come from the Bob. So what has Darth done? Darth has wore a mask of Bob. He is pretending to be Bob, and Alice has been in misconception that he has got a message from Bob, but actually it has come from Darth. The second is replay attack. In that, Bob is sending a message to Alice. Darth captures the message and after some time he replays this message. It is called replay attack. So till now I have focused on two types of active attack. One is masquerade and the second is replay attack. The third is modification of messages and fourth is denial of service. So what happens in modification of the message? Bob is sending a message to Alice. Darth captures this message, modifies and sends it back to Alice. Example is when Bob says to Alice, send me 100 rupees. What a Darth will do? He will add 1020 saying that send me 1000 rupees, 10,000 rupees. So this is called modification of message. The last type of active attack is denial of service, where while the communication is taking place from Bob to Alice, Darth in between sitting disrupts the service or the network. You all are from the computer background, so you know ping message. Ping is sent to realize that the remote computer is working or not. When I talk about denial of service, what Darth does is he keeps on pinging the message till the remote computer is not able to process these pings and not able to reply and it goes down. So this is called denial of service, saying that the attacker has attacked the system in such a way that the system which is being victim is not able to reply. Then my topic is security services. There are five types of security services: authentication, access control, confidentiality, integrity and non-repudiation. I would start with authentication. It says the communicating parties are the same that they are claiming to be. Yani, if I am saying I am Mr. X and transmitting the message, then I am certainly Mr. X. Access control, the second type of security service, it says unauthorized persons cannot use the resources. Third security service is confidentiality, saying that protects data from unauthorized disclosure. Means when data is being transmitted, it is meant for A and B, then nobody else can open the message. That is called confidentiality. Fourth type of security service is integrity. Yani, data received is same as it was sent. Data received is same as it was sent. That means if I have said that come at 10 o'clock to the office, yani data is the same as it is received. Nobody has changed it to 12 o'clock rather than 10 o'clock. Non-repudiation, yani neither the sender or receiver can deny that the message was sent or message was received. For example, I have asked my students to submit the assignment before May 31st and I am sending this email on May 15th. Then student cannot deny that, ma'am, you have not sent a message, right? This is called non-repudiation. So all in all, we focused on five types of security services. The first one was authentication, second access control, third confidentiality, fourth integrity and fifth non-repudiation. Then comes with security mechanisms. Up till now I have talked about attacks, security services and the third part is security mechanism. The first is encipherment. It is nothing but a mathematical algorithm. Data transferred from one to another by using some algorithm and key, And one who looks at the data cannot understand what this data, what information is carried by this data. Digital signature, it is appended to the data so that receiver can identify the source. When you do a stock market transaction, when you have sold some stock, when that transaction comes back to you, it comes with a digital signature so that you can verify that authenticate person has done the transaction. Then comes access control. Resources are always given some access rights through this mechanism. If you have worked on Unix system, you know every object has read, write, execute permission. So with those permissions only, user can either read or write or modify. Data integrity. Data integrity means data has been received. It is the same as it was sent. Authentication exchange. A and B, if two parties want to communicate, they are exchanging the information with their identity. So B can identify that I am talking to A. A can identify that I am talking to B. Traffic padding. We focused on traffic analysis, but if I append some random bits to this traffic, the one who has got the data cannot analyze. So traffic padding is nothing but appending some random data to information. Then comes routing control. Secure routing paths are established so that security threat does not occur. Notarization, the third party, which is trusted, comes into the picture. He will try to give the certificate that these two parties which are communicating has a legitimate certificate and they can communicate. Now the focus is on cryptography. Cryptography has certain key terms. Now I'll try to explain the key terms which are being used in the cryptographic literature. The first term is plain text. The original message which is being transmitted or which is going to be transmitted is called plain text. Message that is being converted to a message that is called coded message, or not understandable message, that is called ciphertext. Encryption is a process that converts plain text to the ciphertext. If we are trying to retrieve plain text from the ciphertext, it is called decryption process or deciphering process. The process of encryption and decryption is called cryptography. And if trying to break the code, then it is called cryptanalysis. Encryption algorithms can be of two types: symmetric algorithm and asymmetric algorithm. As its name suggests, in the symmetric algorithm, key is used, but that key used is same for the sender and receiver. So if you look at the slide, you can see it is written as C equal to E K P. K denotes the key and P denotes the plain text. E says encryption algorithm applied with this plain text and key, which gives the ciphertext. Decryption is a process where you have to supply key and the ciphertext and retrieve the plain text. So it is written as P equal to D K C. K and C are the input to the decryption algorithm. And as I emphasized, decryption and encryption keys are same when we talk about symmetric encryption. Then comes asymmetric encryption. So now it clicks to you the key used for the encryption and decryption are different. So the equation is written as C equal to E K P, but this time we would add suffix E to the K, saying that this is a encryption key. And for decryption, we are using the equation D, K, D and C. This time I have used the suffix D with the K, that is decryption key associated with a decryption algorithm. So now it is clear, encryption key and decryption key are different, then it is called asymmetric encryption. How a cryptography system is built? So there are three main points. The first is type of operations used. It is called substitution and transposition. Substitution is nothing but replacing one character by another character. Transposition means you are changing the order of the character, saying that if there are five characters, then first character would go at a third position, fourth character can come at the second position. So in turn you are changing the positions, that is called transposition. So we are focusing on characteristics of cryptographic systems, and I said first is the number of or type of operations used. The second is number of keys used. The more number of key used, the more secure the algorithm is. The third is the way in which the plain text is processed. In that, again, there are two ways: block cipher and stream cipher. Block cipher, yani you are taking n bit block as an input and getting n bit block as an output. Stream cipher, yani it is taking one bit or one byte as an input and taking it as an output. Then comes cryptanalysis. Cryptanalysis is attack on an encryption system to recover the key rather than getting ciphertext or plain text. Two general approaches are there: cryptanalysis and brute force attack. Cryptanalysis is deriving plain text or key. In that, we are relying on the nature of the algorithm and some knowledge of characteristic of plain text is there. So cryptanalysis is using pair of ciphertext and plain text. Brute force attack is the attacker is trying all possible keys on the ciphertext until the plain text is obtained. Cryptanalysis attacks. So there are five types of cryptanalysis attack: ciphertext only, known plain text, chosen plain text, chosen ciphertext and chosen text. Already emphasized that cryptanalytic attack is trying to get the key rather than focusing on retrieving on the plain text. If a key is retrieved, then attacker can decrypt all other messages those are being transmitted. The first is ciphertext only, in which cryptanalyst knows encryption algorithm and ciphertext. The second is known plain text attack, in which encryption algorithm is known, ciphertext is known, and one or more plain text ciphertext are known with the help of key. The third is chosen plain text. Again, attacker knows encryption algorithm, ciphertext and plain text message chosen by the cryptanalysis. This time he is given the ciphertext corresponding to the plain text generated with the secret key. The next is chosen ciphertext attack, in which encryption algorithm is known, ciphertext is known. This time ciphertext is chosen by cryptanalyst together with the corresponding decrypted plain text. So it's clear, attacker has chosen the ciphertext and accordingly he is given the plain text. Now comes chosen text, in which encryption algorithm is known, ciphertext is known. Chosen text, yani ciphertext chosen by cryptanalyst, then plain text correspondingly given, plain text is chosen by the script analyst, then accordingly the ciphertext is given. Now, probable word attack. So when an electronic fund is being transferred through net banking on the internet, what is known? There are certain parts of the message is known, that in the initial round of or information of the transaction, there are user information being transferred. So if certain informations are known, then it is called probable word attack. Suppose source code from company Z is transferred over the internet, then it is known that in the initial phase, company's copyright or company's name and logo are appended. Now we will talk about unconditionally secure and computationally secure. Can I design any encryption scheme? No. That encryption scheme should be unconditionally secure or computationally secure. Unconditionally secure, yani ciphertext generated by the scheme does not have enough information to uniquely determine the corresponding plain text. No wonder how much ciphertext is available. To summarize, a person should not be able to find out the plain text associated with the ciphertext, though infinite source of ciphertext is available. The encryption scheme is called computationally secure. If either of these two criteria is met, the cost of breaking the cipher is higher than the value of encrypted information. And the second is, information useful lifetime is less than the required time to break the information. So suppose enemy has said that an attack on this at 11 o'clock in the morning, and if we decipher the text at 5 o'clock in the evening, then the attack has already occurred and we have no value of that information. And the last is brute force attack, saying that trying all possible keys until the plain text is obtained from the ciphertext. To summarize today's module, we started with talking about the types of attacks, active attack and passive attack. Then we focused on security attack, security service and security mechanism. Then we tried to cover what is cryptanalyst, trying to recover plain text from the ciphertext, but this time trying to recover the key so that all further messages can be decrypted. Then we focused on what an encryption scheme has a characteristic. It has two characteristics, computationally secure and unconditionally secure. Then the last part we focused on was brute force attack. So brute force attack is trying to get all possible keys to retrieve the plain text. For further information, you can refer to the e-text uploaded. In my next module, I am going to touch upon the symmetric cipher. That will be substitution cipher and permutation cipher, their advantages and disadvantages. Thank you.